First scripture comes from Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future.
Let us walk in the light of the Lord. The people walking in the darkness have seen a great light, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulders.
And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Arise, shine, for your light has come.
Thank you.
You are the light of the world. Let your light so shine before others that they may see your good deeds and give glory to your Father in heaven.
Choir did really well, didn't they? And you know something? You did really well too, to sit here and to watch the choir as carefully as you did. And now the choir is going to join us down here too. And what we're going to do together, the most important part of the service tonight, because it's Christmas Eve, is for us to read together the Christmas story. So I'm going to read the Christmas story to you. And we're together sharing it with a whole group of people that are in the room here. So let's listen to how the writer in the Bible named Luke tells us the story of when Jesus was born. Okay? About that time, Caesar Augustus, who was the ruler, ordered a census to count the people to be taken throughout the empire. This was the first census when Quirinius was governor of Syria. Everyone had to travel to their own hometown to be accounted for, so Joseph went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Bethlehem in Judah. That was David's town. As a descendant of David, he had to go there. He went with Mary, his fiancée, who was expecting a child. And they were there, and the time came for her to give birth, and she gave birth to a son. And she wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger because there was no room in the hotel. There the sheep herders, or the shepherds we call them, in the neighborhood were watching over their flocks by night. Suddenly, the angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory, the light of God, was shining all around them. And guess what? The shepherds were scared because it kind of woke them up. And the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I'm here to announce a great and joyful event that's meant for everybody all around the world. A Savior has been born in David's town, a Savior who is Christ the Lord. And this is what you look for. You'll find the baby wrapped in a blanket lying in a manger." At once, that angel was joined with a whole bunch of other angels, and they were singing God's praises, glory to God in the highest heavens, and on earth, peace on all men and women who please God. As the angel choir withdrew into the heavens, the shepherds talked it over. Let's go over to Bethlehem as fast as we can and see for ourselves what God has revealed to us. And they left running, and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. Seeing was believing, and they told everyone what the angels had told them about this child. And all who heard them were amazed at what the shepherds said to them, but Mary treasured all of these things in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. That's the story of when Jesus was born. And we celebrate that at Christmas time. And we do lots of things. We come to church. We sing Christmas carols. We have ornaments. And if you didn't get one this morning, Miss Paula has some for you as you leave from up here tonight. But that's our way of saying to God, thank you for sending Jesus, and we thank you for the gift of your love. So let's pray together and ask God that in all the things we do at Christmas, we help him to know how much we appreciate what he sent to us in Jesus, and how much we love Jesus, and how we believe in him in our hearts. Would you bow with me? Dear God, this is a really, really special night. And we feel your love and your presence, and we pray that you'll help us as we celebrate your birth to help others celebrate it too. May we show love to others just like you showed us your love when you sent Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you. Thank y'all.
A reading from the book of Colossians, chapter 3, verse 15. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you were called to peace, and be thankful.
It came upon the midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their hearts of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from hands of gracious King.
A reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 13. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love.
Christmas reminds us of the greatest gift that God ever gave us, the gift of His love. And that love is best seen in the coming of Jesus Christ into this world. And when Jesus came, He taught us, greater love hath no one than this, that they lay down their lives for someone else, for a friend. And Jesus said, I don't call you servants, I call you friends. And so He reminded us that part of the goal of our lives is to absorb and to receive and be blessed by and inspired by the love of God that we see in John 3:16 and 17. For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved. So at the end of His time on this earth, right before He went to the cross, right before the resurrection, right before the days that He visited the disciples and then ascended, Jesus assembled all of the disciples together to celebrate what had been a time that represented God's love and His intentionality when it came to His own people, the Passover experience. And so when He gathered the disciples together in that room, Jesus said, let's talk about love. I talk about how greater love hath no one than they lay down their lives for someone else. I want you to know that this is my body broken for you. This is my blood shed for you. And the reason I do it is because I love you. And God whispered to us on that night so long ago when Jesus was born, I'm doing this because I love you. Receiving that love is what this table is about. And that's why it is so beautiful and so appropriate on Christmas Eve for us to gather in this place with a reminder that we become the light of the world through our faith in Jesus Christ, who is the the light that was sent into darkness. So on that evening, the Lord took bread after they had had a supper together. And he said, let me illustrate this to you. He broke the bread, he shared it with his disciples, and he said, this bread is my body that is broken for you. I don't think he said it with a sad tone in his voice, but with almost the excited anticipation of saying, there's something I can do, and I'm willing to be broken for you so that you might be made whole. So he broke the bread and he shared it, and love became very real in that moment. Will you bow with me as we prepare to remember that moment by sharing the bread ourselves? Lord Christ, as we lift up before you this moment, we ask your blessings. Give us, we pray, the understanding that you wanted your disciples to have concerning the importance of the bread, concerning the brokenness of your body, concerning the wholeness that is ours as we have faith and receive this moment, each of us receiving a piece of the whole, which is you. In your precious name we pray, receiving this bread. Amen. this is the bread that came down out of heaven. Not the bread the fathers ate and had to eat again or they would die. Whoever eats this bread in faith will live forever. The body of Christ broken for us. Receive it with me. On that same night, the Lord took a cup and he shared it with his disciples and he said, "This blood, this cup is the new covenant in my blood." He said, "I'm writing something new, doing something new." And he said, "I want this to represent to you that my blood is shed for you and your sins are cleansed." Will you bow with me as we prepare to receive this cup together? Lord, you took one cup and each person had a part. Tonight we share the cup in many forms, with each of us receiving a bit of it ourselves. One source, many people, one faith and salvation. Thank you for the gift that it represents, for the love that was so expensive and wonderful and offered so freely. In your precious name, Lord, as we receive the cup, help us to understand as we look into the manger afresh. Amen.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? And when you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. The blind will see, the dead will hear, and the dead will live again. did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know?
The scripture explains that according to the law, we may almost say that all things are cleansed with blood and that apart from the shedding of blood, sacrifice, there is no remission of sins. But the promise is that if we walk in the light as our Lord Jesus Christ walks in the light, we have fellowship one with another, and the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us from all unrighteousness. It moves us from the sadness of sin to the joy of salvation, and gives us hope and peace through Jesus Christ. Will you share the cup, the blood of Christ, with me? For as often as we eat the bread, as often as we drink the cup, we show forth the Lord's death, His burial, and His resurrection until He comes again. Thank you. A reading from Isaiah 12, verse 6. Shout aloud, sing for joy, people of Zion, for great is the Holy One of Israel among you. It is fulfilled in this night that the Holy One of Israel is with us. Emmanuel has come. And as we light the Christ candle, we see in a moment, we see how we go from the joy of the moment to the love of Christ.
Our scripture is Isaiah 9, verses 2 and 6. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace.
In celebration of the birth of our Savior, we will light the candle of Christ.
Tonight we've revisited the entire Advent experience. We lit the candle of hope, reminding us of what the prophets promised of the coming of this Messiah, that he would be coming and bring peace. And we lit the candle of peace from the light of hope. And from the light of peace and the light of hope, we lit the candle of love, reminding us that it was in God's love that he came. And from hope, peace, and love, we lit tonight the candle of joy. And all of that came together, and we were able to take the same light and light the candle representing the birth of Christ. Jesus said, while I'm in the world, I'm the light of the world. And he said, when I'm gone from this world, you are the light of the world. And we receive our light where? From Jesus Christ himself. So we'll light the sanctuary here, symbolically lighting each of your lives and reminding you that you are the light of the world. And the light will come from one source. Peace, hope, love, joy, the birth of Christ, and into the world through you. May God bless this moment in all of our lives, and may he bless his light in this world.
Glory.